to form hydronium ion. Now let's take an example. Let's take a look at an example at how it reacts with water. Let's take a look at an example of HCl. HCl is called, can somebody tell me what acid this is? Do you guys know?
Hydrochloric.
Very good. Yes, it is hydrochloric acid. Why is it called hydrochloric acid? Because it has one atom of hydrogen and it has one atom of chlorine. So hydrochloric acid. So when hydrochloric acid reacts, when you put hydrochloric acid in water, what happens? The hydrochloric acid releases that H plus ions. Releases H plus ions. Those H plus ions, they react with water to form hydronium ions plus the Cl minus ion. I will tell you what Cl minus is. Hold on. So remember in the previous slide I had told you that, so when I have, I told you ions combine with each other to form compounds. Just like CaCO3 over here, Ca2 plus and CO3 2 minus. These both ions, 2 plus and 2 minus, interacted with each other to form CaCO3. Similarly, HCl is formed how? HCl is formed by one H plus ion and one Cl minus ion. So one H plus ion and one Cl minus ion interact with each other to form HCl. Okay, because there is one over here, I can put one over here and one over here, but it's not needed. Whenever there is one, I just skip it. Only if it's more than one, I write it. So that is how you get HCl. But what did I tell you? Whenever you put acids, whenever you immerse acid in water or in aqueous solution, they release H plus ions. So if I have an acid and my acid is HCl, my acid is HCl is releasing H plus ions, so what am I left? Chloride. Very good. Chloride ion. Chlorine, yes. Very good. Okay, so let me tell you why everybody else is, some people are saying chloride, some people are saying chlorine, and I'll clarify what it is. So actually, both of you are right, but one is chlorine ion or chloride ion, whatever. So I told you H plus. So H plus. Plus Cl minus forms HCl. So H plus ion is being released. As soon as I add HCl in water, all the H plus ions go away from HCl. So I am left with what? Cl minus. So this Cl minus, Cl is called chlorine. Okay. And Cl minus is called chloride. IDE, chloride ion. Okay? Does that make sense to everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So now we know that chloride ion is left. So I have told you that HCl reacts with water, or whenever you put HCl inside water, what happens? The acid releases its H plus ions, and that H plus ion is very, very unstable, so it reacts with water and it forms hydronium ion, and what I am left with is Cl minus. Cl minus is chloride ion. Now, let us go into H2SO4. H2SO4, I mentioned to you in the previous slide, is sulfuric acid. Okay. H2SO4 is called sulfuric acid. When I mix sulfuric acid in water, what happens? Remember over here in sulfuric acid, I have two hydrogens, not just one, I have two hydrogens. So this happens in a step-by-step process. Because I have two hydrogens, first one hydrogen is released and that hydrogen forms, so one hydrogen is released from these two hydrogens and it reacts with this water to form the hydronium ion. and that remaining hydrogen is still left with HSO4. So one take out one hydrogen from here, from H2SO4, I will be left with HSO4 minus. Why minus? Because I have taken away H plus. So H plus is gone, so I am left with HSO4 minus. Does it make sense to all of you so far?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Everyone understood? If you have any doubts, stop me. Okay?
Mom, can you repeat?
Yes, I can repeat. All right. So, did you understand the hydrochloric acid and water, this first equation?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, if you understood this, yes.
What is the symbol between that H2O and H3O plus?
Good. So that symbol is called the reversible symbol, meaning that this reaction can reverse itself also. That means what? So it's a reversible reaction. Have you got, guys, you must have read in your sixth standard, right, that some changes are reversible changes? Some changes. Okay, for example. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
For example, if I change milk to curd, is that a reversible change?
Yes, ma'am.
No. No, yes. I cannot get back milk from curd. I can make curd from milk, but I can't get milk from curd, okay? Similarly, if I evaporate water, will I be able to get water from steam?
Yes.
Yes. Will I be able to get steam from water?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, folding paper and cutting paper.
Folding paper and cutting paper. Very good. Yes. So some changes are reversible. Some changes are irreversible. Okay. So very good, Unmana. So if I look at this reaction, this reaction is reversible. Okay. So that is why the symbol over here, right? So this symbol is actually, if you're not able to see very clearly, I'll draw it. So what that means is like this. And like this, meaning the reaction can go in this direction or it can go in this direction. Either way, okay. That means this is reversible. Clear? Now, yes, Priscilla.
Does that mean in the end that there is one hydronium ion, one water molecule, and sulfate?
Oh, you are talking about the second example?
Yes, sir.
Actually, you are partially right. There is hydronium ion, there is one hydronium ion, one sulfate ion, but there are lots of water molecules. Why? Because I'm adding sulfuric acid to water, right? So there are lots of water molecules, not just one. Okay.
Now, but how can they get more than one? Only one is possible, right?
Ah, good question. I will tell you. Hold on. First, let me explain. I don't remember who that was, but I'll come to your question. Okay. First, let me explain this part.